Hey, so I want to tell you a tiny bit about myself. Megan will introduce herself, give you just enough context, and then we're going to go into Solve for X. When we talk about moonshot thinking, we have in mind these three circles here. We're interested in things that have a point, first of all. There has to be a problem to solve. This is not an academic exercise. This is an exercise in trying to make the world a radically better place. If you can't say what about the world would become radically better, it's not a moonshot. Then, because we mean technology moonshots, we're talking about things where there's a science fiction sounding product or service, which, never mind whether you could actually make it or not, if it were made somehow magically, it would make that problem go away. You have to be able to say that too. And then number three, it's not worth doing unless there's some reason to believe you could actually get it done. Now, this is not about guaranteeing that you can get it done. The essence of a moonshot is that you're going to fail most of the time. Whip Hoyer, Leader Cantor were very sweet to describe us as very smart. I don't think that's actually what's going on. I think we are an exercise at Google X. We are trying to be an exercise in bravery, in being willing to fail most of the time. And I think that's really what the secret to moonshot thinking is having the bravery to try, even though it won't work most of the time. So the reason that we started Solve for X, you know some of the things that we've made public, self-driving cars, Google Glass, the stratospheric ballooning project, Loon, the wind project that we have, Makani. But rather than talk about our stuff, we want to celebrate other people who are taking moonshots and are exhibiting this bravery. Because what really matters is not, Google X couldn't possibly take enough moonshots to save the world. It's not possible. We all need to exhibit this bravery. And so we should spend time, I hope we spend this time together right now, celebrating these people who aren't funded by Google and, you know, don't work for Google, just celebrating their bravery and hoping that more people will exhibit this kind of bravery. So thank you all for coming. Megan Smith, who's my wonderful colleague in Solve for X.
So actually the first thing I was thinking was actually an interesting thing about the moonshot, which is the original creation of NASA, the original decision to do that actually came from these halls. So I want to thank the Congress and Senate, you know, sort of the House and the Senate, for studies on the moonshot path in general and giving us our inspiration. We feel like we've come home for that. So Astro talked a little bit about the premise of a moonshot, and we wanted to create Solve for X as a website, and we thought of doing this and a series of events like this where we hear from amazing innovators as they're in progress. They're going to take us through 10-minute talks. Which will hit these, they'll highlight a large problem in the world, kind of science fiction-like technology that's coming at us that might just work, and a radical way to scale that. So we're going to do that in the area of manufacturing, in the area of STEM and learning, and in the area of really interesting ways to access more resources that we need as a society in an environmentally interesting way. So that's going to be fun. We're going to do, format-wise, they're going to each come up and talk for 10 minutes, and then after that, so that's about 30 minutes, we'll quick intro in between, we're going to break into brainstorming groups. So we'll take 30 minutes together, and we have a rule. It's called two-thirds yes and, one-third yes but. We might need that here. So whenever you hear a proposal, you must spend two-thirds or more of your time at your table trying to help that person. So do you know of resources, do you know of technology, of people, of a project like it, of someone they should be working on, of something that sounds like a good thing that could happen? You're going to spend two-thirds of your time brainstorming. And what's interesting, we have the wonderful AAAS fellows, thanks to Trey, who helped us find all of you, who are a little bit of plants here, who will help with some of the science side if people are feeling nervous about that. But two-thirds yes and. But most of the people, when we do Solve for X, they don't know anything about the idea. And it's awesome to see the contribution that these guys get from you. So please stay and do that with us. One third of the time or less, we want you to do yes, but, which means we really do need to critique these ideas. We need to think through what might not work here. Should we pivot the idea into something else? Should we not do this? Is this sound a little crazy in a way that the physics doesn't work? Talk to us about that too. So we'll do that. And then you guys will appoint someone on your table to come up and report out in last part, and then we'll have a reception. So I guess the one other thing I wanted to say, there's a wonderful piece in the New York Times today about heroic contributions of women scientists. And one of the things that Astro and I have been doing as we worked with these incredible partners who are also moonshot thinkers and have videos and others up there, is how to make sure that the voices of all the innovators, which is substantially everyone now that we're networked, you know, that can innovate, are really coming through, and not just majority people who've always had access, but men and women, people from different countries, people from different walks of life, people from different races and different cultural backgrounds are really coming together to collaborate. And the interesting thing is that really research is starting to show is the more diverse a team is, the more exceptional the results are. It may be a little uncomfortable, the research shows that too, but the product and the result and the company and everything are just so much better. And so we have a real attention to that. And so without further ado, let's get started with the first one. I think Astro's gonna.
I've gotta go, but two-thirds yes and works in a democracy.
Excellent. Okay.